Leah Selkirk and I'm an associate in the healthcare team at Hill Dickinson. The eagerly anticipated judgment from the Court of Appeal on the RECE matter has landed today, and so I just wanted to provide a very quick video update. A link to the judgment is below, so make sure you click on it and have a read. So just as a reminder, this case concerns whether a care plan's facilitator sees contact with a sex worker could be implemented without an offence under the 2003 Sexual Offences Act being committed by a care staff assisting C to have such contact. C has capacity to consent to sexual relations and decide to have contact with a sex worker, but he doesn't have capacity to make the arrangements himself. The judge in the initial court protection proceedings concluded that the assistance C would require from carers would not fall within the causing or inciting interpretation under the Sexual Offences Act when applying their obvious meaning. The judge determined that it would not be unlawful for C's carers to support him to have access to a sex worker, and this provided a gateway opportunity for a care plan to be prepared and assessed in order to consider whether being supported to access a sex worker would be in C's best interests. The Secretary of State applied for permission to appeal and was granted permission to appeal, and that was on the basis that the judge at first instance fell into error in his interpretation of the words causing or inciting within section 39 of the Sexual Offences Act by failing to give the words their natural meaning. Their position was that had the judge given the words their natural meaning, he would have concluded that even where C has capacity to consent to sexual relations and have contact with a sex worker, by assisting him to do so, a carer would commit an offence under section 39. The Court of Appeal heard the case in July and the judgment has landed today. The headline is that the Court of Appeal has granted the Secretary of State's appeal, meaning that the arrangements envisaged for securing the services of a sex worker for C would place the care workers concerned at risk of committing an offence contrary to section 39 of the Sexual Offences Act. And fundamentally, C's care plan cannot proceed on such arrangements, as it is of course imperative that any package of care is lawful so as not to place any carers liable to criminal prosecution. Interestingly, the Court of Appeal in its judgment touches on the comparison of care workers who arrange contact between a mentally disordered person and a spouse or partner, being aware that sexual activity may take place between them. However, in these circumstances, the court commented that this would more naturally be creating the circumstances for that activity rather than causing it in the legal sense. But what the court does say is that is something to be left open for argument in the appropriate case. We'll have to wait and see whether permission is sought to appeal to the Supreme Court on this one, so watch this space.